I wish I knew how it would feel to be free. I wish I...
I'm Dan Seguin, and I'm in North Bay, Ontario, and I'm on a main street called Cassells, and I love doing big displays, and at least I used to like doing big displays, but the city and I have come to some type of friction on certain issues. I run a business. Part of my business is hauling garbage, and I'm on a commercial property, and I sell secondhand goods, at least the stuff that people sometimes throw out that I can make money on. And the city and I have had issues for probably more than 11 years, and this is my story.
Wish I could break all the chains holding me. I wish I could say all the things that I should say. Say them loud, say them clear, for the whole round world to hear. I wish I could share all the love that's in my heart. Remove all the bars that keep us apart. I wish you could.
My name is Roberta, and I'm Daniel's wife. We purchased this house in 1996, and he started doing displays that year. This is the first display that he ever did.
This thing is amazing. Every occasion that you can mention, this guy has everything all decorated. It could be Halloween, it could be Christmas, it could be... It's amazing. It's like, how many people do you know in North Bay that would ever do anything like this?
Dan's awesome. He's always doing things for every occasion. I think it's great.
Excellent. You like it?
Oh yeah, I've just walked three blocks to come over for it.
I like this house. I mean, the people who make this house make a good job from here. Every holiday, every season, there's something trippy going on.
Yeah.
I want to know how my displays originated. my father had what we call an orange hall, which is an old dance hall that was about 100 years old up at the old Chadburn and 4 Mile Lake Road in North Bay. And I was only like, I think maybe 6 or 7 when he had bought this property. We were together and he was looking for a property and I'd spotted it and I'd said, hey, that looks cool, you know. So next thing you know, he ended up buying it. And he started, after he put the fence 1 or 2 years later, he started putting a Christmas lights around the fence and on the orange hall. And anyways, he ended up doing it every year. And it was, I always helped him he would get all of the old Christmas sets and refix them. And we would all sort the old light bulbs and the good light bulbs and mix the colors. And it just ended up being something that as a kid, my dad was doing. I got excited, started helping him. And a lot of fun times in the cold weather. But I felt maybe I could start doing it here, kind of bring it in memory of him here. And I thought, you know, as a young person, looking up to my dad doing it, and then my dad would go, after the lights were on, the people would drive by. And we'd go and hide behind some trees, and he'd say, look at these people, like, look at their reactions on their face. They're like little kids all over again. The other side of this battle with the city is that I feel that I've lost the passion that I used to have doing the displays. And if you don't have passion, you don't have half of what it takes to work hard, play hard, or whatever. The passion is what motivates everybody to, you know, be able to accomplish big things. You know, I never tried to upset the city or disrespect the bylaws. However, I felt I had a right to defend myself. You know, this is Canada. It's a free country, and there are laws that supposedly protect me without supposedly having retaliation or being ambushed into eventually giving up and letting them have what they want.
The property's not being targeted per se as compared to any other property. There is some increased enforcement on that property, as well as there's litigation ongoing, and that's a result of numerous complaints.
And have you seen the back? Like, they have all the washing machines and bicycles and TVs. Like, there's a bunch of garbage back there, right?
Kind of change that, like, change his ways a little bit.
This property, like, if I, like, go and touch it right now, he'd freak out.
City officials certainly see me in a different light, and I mean, I know there's a lot of wealthy people and a lot of people that have nice homes and stuff, and they like the city, and they think, you know, that every house should be a certain way, and every house should look a certain way, and all these streets should be a certain way. And I do believe also that, yes, bylaws should be followed.
The property at Cassells St, there's a few issues that are taking place currently. It's currently in breach of a 2006 court order. That's to, in regards to the amount of lot coverage that's allowed, as well as an ongoing and day-to-day issue is illegal parking on the side on 7th Avenue, adjacent to 1135 Cassells St.
It has now been 8 properties that the city has gone after me on. It has been over 100 no parking tickets, of which I beat over 74 tickets before. Majority of them being on the grounds that I was loading or unloading my vehicles. Now they've changed it that I can't even load or unload my vehicles. They can basically tow my vehicles away. And how am I supposed to, if I load and unload all the time, supposed to make a living if that's part of my business? So this is what the city has done, in my opinion, to just make it harder for me to make a living here and eventually just get me to get the to want to get the heck out of here.
We don't target individuals. You know, there's no Machiavellian, you know, kind of grand scheme to go out and cause an individual, you know, problems. But certainly we also take our jobs very seriously. And as I said earlier, we make every effort to work with people initially to achieve compliance. However, you know, if they resist that, there are other mechanisms available to us. And we'll do what we need to do to ensure that you know, the community is protected, the public good is protected.
I was warned before, if you start challenging the city and you win with them, you'll win a battle, you'll never win the war. They'll continue with all the other ways that they can. They got endless resources and endless money. And I was basically proven right. And even if I win, it's a hollow victory because they eventually get their way one way or another. God, it'd be nice to just be able to fix this amicably, like I've suggested to the former mayor and to former city officials, that I don't know if it really was heard.
Generally, it's always our intent is to work with people to try and achieve compliance. And you know, we think that the bylaws are reasonable bylaws. They've certainly been upheld in the courts, and you know, we have a long-standing record both with the City of North Bay, but municipalities in general in Canada have bylaws, and in fact around the world, that regulate use of properties. So, you know, we're always willing to work with people, but by the same token, you know, the people have to be willing to work with us.
There is some public perception from time to time that the city's not actively working towards a solution in this problem. For the most part, almost everything is before the courts at this point, so we don't really have the option of speeding it up. The court process will take a certain amount of time, and that's what we are bound by at this point. Charges are in front of the courts, and we just have to wait for that process to take its course.